So, hello, good afternoon, Anna Devic. Anna Devic is a member, one of four members of VHV collective, originally from Croatia. And we will talk today about the VHV Academia, a school that the collective founded in 2018. I prepared a few questions, and the questions actually rely or kind of use a little bit your title, why, how, and for whom, meaning why you founded a school, how it works, and for whom is it conceived. So the first question would be why did you start VHV Academia? What was the most immediate reason, or what were the most immediate reasons to start an art school?
Thank you, Vít. So nice to be here with you and to have a chance to talk about the importance of education and some experiences of VHV Academia. To start with, I will say that VHV Academia is a new program for emerging artists. We started it in 2018. So far, we had two editions. We call them generations of VHV Academia. So the idea was to intervene in the existing educational system for the artists, not only in Croatian context or in regional context, but also on the international level. We can say that we were quite inspired by the experiences and formats that Homeworks from Lebanon and Beirut has been testing with Christina Tome for many years. So we are also grateful to our colleagues who before us approached this quite critical question of the future and of the present of education for artists, with artists, and I would say that this perhaps answers your question to whom it is for. And we also try, well, coming from the collective position and from the long experience of working collectively, working on the independent scene for many years, our idea was that we try to translate a little bit some of the experiences that we as a collective achieve so far in the formats of exhibition making and programming of different type. We start from this idea of conscious citizen. And the idea is to offer a broad educational spectrum to our participants, but also to try to incorporate some values and methodologies that can be also applicable in the wider social and political life, so outside of the field of art. We were very much inspired by this Brechtian idea of learning by doing, and we see that as a crucial element in the educational processes. So the idea is that we try to encourage our participants that actively with us co-produce a critical content. And in that sense, we are collectively producing together new methodologies of co-learning. So technically, VHV Academia usually incorporates 8 to 15 international students. Our academic year lasts between 7 to 8 months. And it is not only a tuition-free program, it is also a program that offers its participants stipends that partake in covering their costs of staying in Zagreb. Academia is realized in partnership with Contact Collection from Vienna, who focuses on experimental and neo-avant-garde art in Central, Eastern, and Southeastern Europe from late 50s onwards. So the idea is that through this partnership, we are also trying to rethink our curriculum from the very position of these practices coming from the territory of so-called Eastern Europe, that in many ways with their imagination, alternative and more autonomous ways of producing and contextualizing art are informing and inspiring our program.
Mm-hmm. So maybe I would go a little bit on the beginning what you have been saying. What is the relation of your school to existing public art schools and private art schools in Croatia? How is the situation in Croatia in general in art education, and what kind of like your activity or academia's activity tries to cover or kind of substitute?
So I said that while intervening in the existing system, we try to translate a little bit of what we achieved in the process of the exhibition making. So on a good side, still, and that was a part of some struggles that happened since 10 years ago in Croatia, we can say that the good moment is that education is mostly still public. And it means that in some situations, it is also for free for the students. Mm-hmm. On the more critical side, our stance was that education was and still is mostly conservative, in a sense that these kind of programs are not hosted by official academies or some kind of, let's say, universities or programs that have better infrastructure than the infrastructure of VHV Academia. Also, by establishing this program, we wanted to reclaim the right that we inherited from socialism and that we need to nurture also nowadays. This is a right for free education. And so although the program is mostly through its structure of 2-week intensives, series of workshops with visiting and also resident professors and guest professors, actually focused on the small group that we host in Zagreb. We also, since the very beginning, initiated a public program of VHV Academia called Evenings with VHV Academia. So it means that our idea was that we need to share the program, the participants, some of the tools that we achieved, also with local and with international communities. And also lately, we have been witnessing with this crisis of education, crisis of economy, crisis of, I would say, our societies on more global level, a wish and spark also coming from some institutions here in Croatia and I would say in wider region, that they want to establish a collaboration and they also start to transform themselves. So I would say that this diagnosis of the institutions, formal institutions being still conservative, is in a process of change and that it will change in near future. Mm-hmm. This is a more optimistic point of view. But somehow I see also the responsibility of VHV Academia and also programs of independent background as some agents that can also catalyze this, I hope, fruitful collaborations between, not only between independent organizations, only related to already where there is this compatibility in program, but also with institutions like academies, universities, because our students, our participants are actually coming from that kind of institutions. Mm-hmm.
So maybe if you can just give us an outlook, what kind of students are actually applying, where they are from, that's first question. Maybe second question, you mentioned that that the program is for emerging artists. So in which kind of age or kind of stage of career the artists apply? And the third question related to them, maybe how do you proceed with the selection actually? Because I suppose that more people applies that academia can accept, or how do you kind of deal with this selection procedure?
So we try to target participants who already graduated from some programs, mm-hmm. but are in this space of in-between. So they already are engaged with some exhibitions and with some projects yet they're in this critical period when they need more time and input and support to be able to continue developing their practices. And
kind of post-graduation school in a way, kind of
post-graduation. In some examples, we also had people who were, for example, in the final year of graduation, and they were at the same time participating in the program of VHV Academia. And age-wise, something, let's say, early 20s till mid-30s would be like a range generational-wise, because also we didn't want to limit ourselves, because people are having different kind of production dynamics, and this I would say range proven to be quite I would say positive, because one of the criteria that we employ while choosing and talking to students, it's this willingness to experiment, this willingness to try something that was not yet there in their practices. Mm-hmm. And also to mention that we have an advisory board of VHV Academia. Apart from VHV, David Maljković, Katrin Romberg, director of the Contact Collection. This is also Christine Tome from Homeworks, and Emily Petik, who now is the director of Rijks Academy in Amsterdam. So these are our long-term partners, friends, and colleagues with whom we have been discussing this idea for many years. And in many sense, inputs coming from their sides is crucial in a sense how we are tailoring our programs. And quite often they are also participating in the process of interviewing and reviewing the participants.
And the participants, they are mainly from ex-Yugoslavia, or also it's related with the language. Do you teach in English or in Croatian, or which language do you use actually?
Of course, we teach in English, universal language of the art world, so-called international English, though we also host some native speakers. So our first generation, we called it pilot generation, was mostly composed of local participants from Croatia. Mm-hmm. And we had international participants coming from Eastern Europe, Western Europe, but mostly Europe. Mm-hmm. And for the generation that finished in late May, we wanted to broaden the scope of participants. So we had 10 participants from different European countries, less of the presence from Croatia, people from the region, but also people from different, I would say, cultural situations, like from South America, because Russia, because we wanted to broaden the scope and broaden this kind of the cultural input and heritage that students are bringing. Because I said that program to a large extent is based on this co-creation. Our thinking was that having a broad spectrum of students will bring up diversity to our program. And this has proven, I would say, quite productive. So in the future, we would like to keep up with this international direction, no matter of the challenges that Corona crisis is imposing on us. It is quite important to preserve that. At the same time, it's also important to support the artists coming from the local and the regional context.
So you kind of rely to this Brechtian idea of learning by doing, as you said, and so it's kind of actually a schooling related with a kind of production of, as you said, exhibition, or what kind of actually doing this doing and contains? How do you set up, if it's an exhibition or if it will be a publication, or how the project appears? And more practically, maybe, what were the projects of the first two years that you undergone?
We utilize the format of the exercise. This is also due because we are inviting participants to try out some new approaches, some new practices, especially during the immersive processes of two-week intensives. Also, the idea behind Vekove Akademija is to enable this moment of trial and error so that we don't know everything in advance. And this is how this idea of learning by doing can be done. Only through testing and through allowing some experimentation, some change of the direction, and also making errors. And this is not possible to achieve with participants if someone who is in the position of mentor not able also to experiment. So to a certain extent, this challenge of trying things, it's something that we also allow to ourselves and to our professors. So each of the professors have a chance to also test their own methodology. Of course, we are giving an input, what could be a focus and how it can be done, but somehow professors have freedom.
Just a small question, professors. I suppose that it includes theorists as well as practical, as artists. So it's a kind of interdisciplinary body of professors, right?
Yes, that's quite important. Thank you for mentioning that. Because for the intensives, we try to balance between curatorial and artistic positions. Also, the other visiting professors come from different disciplines, as you said, theory, curatorial practices, sometimes also some theories outside of the field of art, activism, etc. And since the very beginning, this moment of performative, of bodily gestures, because collective is a physical body, and in that sense, we encourage different kind of actions that our visiting professor did in collaboration with participants. In the first year, we had Pierre Balblan in collaboration with Manuel Pelmus. And last year, we invited again Manuel Pelmus to be one of the visiting professors for the intensives, because it has proven that, especially during this experimental performative gestures, some new fields can be opened up. And sometimes that also means stressing a lot about whether this will be publicly done or it will be just done in this shelter of a studio, of a sheltered space of academy. And although we don't put the pressure on the participants to do public parts, they happen through this kind of organic exchange between all of us, and we also encourage these actions. So we had lots of group performances, public actions, exhibitions, and because I said that contact collection is a source of inspiration for us, we very often...
That was my next question, actually. Well, how do you conceive... This is quite unique, I think, at your school, that it's related with a kind of existing amazing collection of East European avant-garde. So how this relation functions, or how do you develop this relation to existing, actually, historical artworks?
It's really amazing what Pierre Bablan and Manuel Pelmus did in relation to contact collection. So they presented the works and the practices of the authors who were engaged with the body. And they were studying collectively scores, bodily performative gestures that are already part of the collection. And this was, for example, done in relation not only to the practice of the Eastern European artists like Tomislav Gotovac or some others, but also in relation to Valley Export, Hans Eschle Scheier, a number of artists who are part of the collection. So I would say that it is an ongoing research We also encouraged participants that they research the collection by themselves, because it is a quite interactive website that can be researched individually. And also through the VHV's work, we, of course, are talking about works by Mladen Stilinović. Sanja Ivejković was for 2 years one of the residential professors of VHV Academia. So we try to engage with the practices that are represented in the collection. Mm-hmm. And for example, for the first exhibition that VHV curated in collaboration with the participants, that was called Midterm, we invited them that they view the collection and that they choose one or two works that seem quite important to them. Not in a sense that they are trying to find an influence, more like a trigger that will then push them into a direction of their own research. And this has proven also quite productive. Because when people are coming to Zagreb, people from the context of Eastern Europe are familiar with those practices. Mm-hmm. And participants from other cultural and geopolitical territories are not so much familiar. So for them, mm-hmm. it is an act of learning, and for students who already are familiar, act of relearning. And the last year, David Maljković and Kate Sutton were as a team part of the residential professorial team, and they both stressed this moment of agility of the practices from Eastern Europe, in a sense that they mostly work with limited production and material resources, using some gestures that were in a sense done without the mediation of the galleries and museums. And we are using that as an encouragement for the participants to think through the limitations of the current COVID situation. So that although we were quite pressed by the situation, while using these practices as a kind of beacons, we use the situation of limitation as a space of quite creative production.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So Anna, I think we kind of expanded the time a little bit, but it was really interesting. And thank you very much for your insight in VHV Academia activities, and hope that I could meet you soon.
I hope we will meet you soon. And for the end, just the last words from me. Thank you for inviting us. And also something that I would share with many colleagues worldwide who are engaged with education. With the crisis, it is quite clear that the question of care is the most critical one at the moment. So while doing educational situations, we are also caring for each other, not only from the position of the mentor students, but also as a kind of a bigger international community engaged with thinking through this crisis about our future.
So, thank you for a nice conclusion. Bye bye.
Bye bye.